to you live. I'm just gonna start some primer if I could find it. Only about a pea-sized amount of primer. That'll go some long way. Just gonna close your pores, fills in fine lines. I'm gonna make sure your face is just prepped for makeup. Make sure it'll last all day. Make sure your eyes don't crease. Hi guys. What are you guys doing? Of course, I was just resting the back of my hands because it feels so good. I'm gonna start my brows. Oh goodness, as I throw my brow on here, I'm gonna use a medium brow liner. Oh god, been cat hair already, goodness. How you guys doing? Hi Jasmine. Hi Angela. Awesome, Sarah, first time. Hey, Shayona. Hey, Rosalinda. Anybody else first time catching me live? Awesome, Laura. Yeah, first time too. Can you guys see the sparkle in my brow? I don't know. I got cream shadow already somehow in my brow. I don't know. I think it's a little bit on here. But I think some of the sparkle of the cream shadow is like already in my brow and I haven't even touched it yet. Some must have gotten on here somehow. We're going to have some glittery brows today and it'll be okay. Oh, I love this brow liner. I never used to do my brows and I don't know how, like now that I didn't used to. But it's really nice because it's really thin so it's easy to work with. I love the comb. If you comb it through, you're gonna keep getting it more natural, basically. And it's smudge proof and water resistant. That's the best way. So I know it's not gonna go anywhere all day. Hi, Teresa. Hi, Perla. Hi, Peyton. Hi, Teresa. Awesome, Cody. If you go to uniquebeautybykayla.com, and this goes for anybody, you can shop there, of course, too. But if you click the join button, then you click register now, and then the type of business is individual. Hi, Tracy. Awesome. First time. First time paid in, very nice. Awesome, Danny. I'm glad when I come on different times, I always get different people. Awesome, Haley. But yeah, so I personally just always trace the top of my brow, then kind of comb it into my hair to blend it in. Oh my goodness, my allergies are already killing me. Oh, the video's barely even started yet. God. I realize where the sparkles come from. The end of this has elegant. I must have tapped it in there somehow. Has elegant cream shadow. That's where the sparkle's coming from. On my brow. Well, it'll be okay today. I use the medium brow liner. And there's light and then there's dark. Hi, Taylor. Yep, Jasmine. Awesome, Brianne. Awesome, Allison. Thank you, Cindy. Hey, Christina. Wisconsin, very cool. Thank you, Becky. Hi, Jennifer. Just make sure to comb that through too. It's just gonna make it as natural as possible. And then I just use the brow gel too, just a little bit to kind of keep them in place. My arches don't always like to stay up, so this kind of helps just a little bit, but it doesn't leave it too stiff or anything. I just go the opposite way of the hair growth, and then with the hair growth. No, I got a new background a couple days ago, finally. Hey, Michaela. Hey, Caitlin. Thank you, Angela. Hi, Tiffany. Yes, I had a lot of the new background too. And it really just gives, more than like the fact that it looks pretty, I like that it gives the light, because I use like fake light, you know, instead of natural lighting, since I come on when it's like the middle of the night here. Usually, it's nice because it gives that background to like bounce off of the light so I don't get as shiny. Hi, Rosa. Thank you, Becky. Yeah, exactly. Yes, I like the fake wood look. Okay, so we're gonna go through cream shadows. We're gonna start with Elegant. Where's my cream shadow brush? I'm just gonna use just a little bit of the Elegant. Just get a little bit at the end. Might even be too much. Wipe just a little bit of that off. Put a little bit in the front, you know, the bottom too. Keep this whole front little area just nice and bright. By just doing a light color in the front, you're always gonna make your eyes open and pop bigger. Awesome, Sydney. If you have questions or need any help more with color or anything like that, definitely let me know. Of course. Oh no, definitely nervous. And my first time doing lives was even more nerve-wracking. Oh, definitely. But I actually, after I started to get a following with lives, I actually started to feel more comfortable. Sounds weirder, the more people I get, I don't know, I like having the conversation versus just kind of talking to just a camera. So I actually prefer a live now. But no, videos definitely were super nerve-wracking. If you want to go embarrass me, you can go back and look at my first some videos from like the end of last year, early this year. Oh goodness. Bad. Even a couple months ago, like when I first started doing lives, was bad. But practice is key. Getting out of your comfort zone is fun. Ends up being better. Hi, Sandy. Hello. Awesome, Lisa. Yes, Elegant to start. Hi, Brooke. Usually about 15 to 20 minutes. It took me a couple minutes longer today for some reason. I guess I was like answering messages at the same time too, so it's always hard to tell exactly how long it takes. I'm always distracted doing a million other things, but took me a little bit longer. I was supposed to come on here like right on the hour and it was like 7 minutes after, so it took me a little longer than normal today, but it's okay. It turned out good, so I'm happy. It's always finding for me the happy medium, because I like volume, but I don't want to look like a crazy person, because there's sometimes where I like do my hair and I'm like, that is way too much volume, I have to like pin some down. So I'm always trying to find the happy medium, because I want volume, definitely. But sometimes I like over tease or over curl. Hey, Daisy. Awesome, Brandy. Just send me a picture of you in natural lighting. So something like outside or by a window, something not like fluorescent, like bathroom lighting is like the worst. It's hard to tell. It's dark shadows, all that kind of stuff. It's hard to really tell. And sometimes fluorescent lighting will give you a little yellow hue, even though your skin might not have that hue. So natural lighting is best. Awesome, Emily. It's good. How's everybody's Friday going? Yes, I've tried. So hopefully I can figure it out. I've tried these colors together. So I'm gonna go through Defiant now. This is a gorgeous color. Matches my shirt, which I just got yesterday. but this Defiant's a gorgeous, gorgeous color. If you have blue eyes, this is a gorgeous color to use. Orange and blue are opposite sides of the color wheel. So by using this like coppery orangey color, great. I think it's great for obviously any eye color. Everybody can wear it. But if you have blue eyes, especially, Defiant is a gorgeous color. And I totally wear it just with Elegant. I've actually totally worn this alone too. It looks gorgeous alone. But just that and Elegant looks really good together, which is the first color I used. But I've tried to attempt, and then I'm going to use Tenacious too. I've tried to attempt these three colors together many different times, but I think I found a way that works a little better. Usually I try to start with Tenacious, the darkest. But I figure now I worked it in, ending with it is the best. I cut it a couple days ago now, probably like 3 days ago now, 3-4 days. But yes, I cut a little bit more. More of my layers than anything. Each time I cut it, I don't really touch the front. The back just keeps bothering me. And it's definitely better when it's curly, but when it's straight, it bothers me when I turn my head and like, I don't know, it's on my shoulders. Like that in between length. So like, I like when it's just above my shoulders and I can turn my head and it's just, oh, I love it off my neck. But it's also not too, too short that I can't put in a ponytail. I always like to put my hair up like at night and stuff too, or you know, when I go to the gym, all that kind of stuff, I like to be able to put it up. Like, I really, like, I did an inverted bob, like, where it's short in the back, longer in the front, years ago, and I really want to do that again, but I really like to put my hair up, so I'm going back and forth. So, yeah, I gotta figure that one out. Thank you, Carrie. The cream shadows are 26 each, or you can get a 3-pack for 70. Yeah, 70. Yeah, yeah. Three of them for 70. So if you want any sets, and this goes for basically any of our products, come in sets, whether it's our eye colors or lip colors, comes in usually sets of three. Some comes in like full sets of 10, if some have 10, like the lip glosses or the eyeliners. This comes in sets of 10 as well, but a lot of them come in sets in three. So if you just go to uniquebeautybykayla.com and click sets and collections, it'll show all different sets, because it saves you about, I don't know, I think 10-15% if you want to get basically more than one of anything. But these cream shadows seriously last forever. Tenacious, this one was the first one I got. That was in my presenter's kit when I joined the beginning of November last year. Don't use it crazy often, so don't get me wrong, but when I first joined, like, I didn't have all these products when I first joined. Until like maybe 3 months in, I didn't have like much products, like, at all. Like, I had skincare, foundation, only the pressed powder. That was all I started with, honestly. And a couple shadows. I think I had all three shadow palettes. And then Tenacious and maybe Elegant were the only cream shadows I had. So I used this a lot in the beginning. I haven't used it a crazy amount now, but they last a very long time. And as long as you keep it screwed on very tight and don't leave it open, it's not going to dry out. And even if it dries out, they said you can put rose water. I haven't done it because mine's never dried out, but you can put rose water to basically bring back the life to it. But they're creams that dry to a soft powder finish, so they're not gonna crease on you or anything like that, which is awesome. And you physically can apply it with your finger, but I find it very, this brush, I think it's like $12 too, and it's synthetic and really is built to last. You can keep washing it over and over again. But the bristles are nice and tight, and you see how thin that is. It's really easy to kind of maneuver the products where you want it. We have a new cream shadow, Victorious. Did you see the picture I showed yesterday? It's awesome. It kind of reminds me of Elegant, but a matte version and a little bit more like tan version of this. I'm really excited. It's gonna be the same kind of texture. As you can see, like, this matte has a different texture than the creams. We're coming out with a new cream, matte cream shadow every month, and I'm so excited. So Victorious releases tomorrow along with our liquid lipsticks. Oh my god, I cannot wait. I hope it doesn't take like 2-3 weeks again to get my products here. Let me see what comments I missed. Awesome, Michelle, thank you. No, I got highlights. You can see the blonde highlights. My roots, that's my natural, is underneath. This is all my natural. It kind of looks a little darker in this lighting, but it's like a light brown, basically. It used to be closer to blonde when I was younger, but you know, as you get older, your hair starts getting darker. Hi, Rachel. Hi, Patsy. Rosewater is a skincare product, so that's what it's mainly meant for, but there's so many other uses in general. If your mascara starts to get a little dry, just squirt a squirt in it, and it's good. Like I said, if these get dry, which is only what's going to happen if you leave it open. I've never had that issue of it getting dry, because I just close it tight, but I've heard people say rosewater will fix that. Pigments, if you want to get the loose pigments, if you want to get them wet, it's just going to make them kind of like a pressed pigment. Use that, but it's mainly a skincare product. I spray it after, if you want to watch, I just did a skincare video a couple days ago, but you just spray it after you wash your face every morning, every night. It balances the pH of your skin, so it's going to balance, if you have more oily or dry, it's going to kind of balance that out to what it's supposed to be. Helps with acne, helps with pore size, like reduced pore size, has so many benefits. It's a toner, it feels great. It's definitely awesome. That's awesome, Rose. I'll work with it, though, if it's short. But yeah, permian definitely damages your hair. I started with Elegant and Defiant, the cream shadow brush. Red colors for what, eyes or lips? Because of course we have red lip colors. And you can use any lip colors on eye colors. You can use any eye colors on lips. All our products are very versatile, and because they're all naturally based, there's no chemicals, it's not gonna hurt, you know, your eyes by putting a lip product near your eyes. I mean, you're not gonna stab yourself in the eye with it, but it's not gonna hurt that, and you can put eye products on your lips and it's gonna be fine. Just a normal curly iron. I've shown how I cut my hair on here before. Has changed your house since COVID? Oh goodness. Yes, I think rosewater is amazing. It's amazing skincare product, like I said. It's great for any skin type. It's, like I said, it's balancing your pH to where it's supposed to be, which is at 7. If it's too high, it's you know, it can be more oily. If it's too low, that means it's too dry. So it balances out what it's supposed to be. Thank you, Kaylee. I'm good, Gladys. How are you? Thank you, Kaylin. Me too. Okay, so let's go through Tenacious. I love this color too. A lot of people are scared because it looks kind of dark. I used to wear this alone all the time because, like I said, this came in my presenter's kit and I didn't just have money to just spend all this money on, you know, all these products. Like, I eventually started to earn, you know, I have every product now, but I've been working the business almost a year now, so I've been earning my makeup. But this is what I started with and this is what I used all the time and I like it a lot. Not even too much. Just get some on the end. And this is totally gorgeous alone. I used to always wear it alone. Maybe a month. It's hard. My first month, I didn't do that much or try that hard. I guess as soon as I started talking about the opportunity, like right away, because I mean, this is obviously an amazing opportunity. I mean, you get $99, you spend $99 for your kit, you get over $200 worth of makeup. There is no commitments whatsoever. You do not have to sell. You don't have to buy. There's no fees. No fees at all. If you want to stay an active presenter, you just buy or sell 125 in a rolling 3 months. But if you don't, you have 6 months after that time to reactivate your account, if not, or else then you stop being a presenter. But you're not literally not charged one penny if you decide you never want to buy or sell anything again. Like, it's an amazing opportunity. I mean, I'm here in Japan, not in the military. I know that I can have a job wherever we go now because everything's just done online. Like, I don't know. It's amazing. And the products are amazing. The products are literally why I joined. It's definitely a great opportunity. So if any of you guys are interested, I'd love to work with you too. I have my own team and training pages, so I'd love to help you get started and start your business. Or even if you just want a discount, that works too. Eyes always so much harder to do. You guys have any questions right now? I'm just gonna keep saying this until people stop poaching my page, but I don't work with anybody. I answer all my messages personally, so if you get any friend requests or messages from anybody else, just know it has nothing to do with me. You can obviously talk to whoever you'd like, but there's people that are always poaching my page and will, any comments, you know, that they see, they'll message you or a friend request you and try to get you to join their team or buy from them. And of course, like I said, you can talk to whoever you'd like, talk to people you connect with. If you connect with them better than me, then you join them. But they'll lie and say that they work for me, and that's just a lie. So just so you guys are aware. Awesome, Christy. I think I'm maybe at like 118 now, something like around there. Awesome, Francis. Yes, love the fall colors. It's probably the best part of fall. Thank you, Becky. I used to be a bold person with makeup, but definitely just with time. It's fun. But I totally never used to wear a lot of makeup. That's why it takes a little bit for my husband to get used to me wearing makeup. I'm just gonna go back through with a little bit of this Defiant to make sure it's all blended in. This eye is always so much harder to do. I swear I can't see. You have any questions about anything? Should I do anything under my brow? And if so, what? Sorry, I want to take this tenacious up a little higher. I never really thought about it until recently, but the reason I like to keep this up higher, it actually makes your eyes, of course I had to blend it out, but by doing kind of higher here and lower there, like with the dark, it kind of makes your eyes like look more lifted. So if you kind of have like more eyes that like to be saggy or whatever, like I didn't wear, because I didn't come on live yesterday, I didn't wear eye makeup yesterday, and I kept looking at my eyes and why do they look so like dead and asleep? I realized because I keep wearing makeup like this, and I like it because I feel like it makes my eyes look awake and uplifted, and I love it. Nothing, which is my husband's favorite look, or just neutral browns. Yeah, all these cream shadows are shimmery. We just started releasing matte cream shadows, so our first matte cream shadow released last month, the 15th actually, this month. I don't even know what month it is. September 15th is when this released. Happy cream shadow. And then tomorrow, Victorious is our new cream shadow that releases tomorrow. It's similar to Elegant, but matte, like I said, because we're releasing one new matte shadow every month for the next 6 months. They have like a different consistency, but they're very easy to apply just like these are, and they don't crease just like these. But it's a little bit like this, but I posted a picture yesterday if you want to go check that out, but a little bit more kind of like... It reminds me of this, wait, is this Prudent? Kind of reminds me of this lip liner color, but for a shadow. Thank you, Jocelyn. Awesome, Kara. Do you guys think, should I do anything on the brow or no? You can obviously see how easy this blends up. I don't know if you can tell. Elegant, defiant, and tenacious. Internet. Yes, all about the fall colors. Most days I just use bronzer, and I prefer a very subtle contour. I don't like a very harsh contour for me in my personal preference, but I also use the contour kit once in a while. Kind of depends what your preference is. The reason I use bronzer more is just because it's a little, has a slight shimmer to it, not like sparkle, but a slight like shimmer and glow to it, which I like. But if you like a full matte, that's what's nice about our contour kit, and I'll use that once in a while too. But this is really nice because it has obviously the contour, the highlight, and then it's got the 3D shimmer part. Hey Pamela. Hey Alyssa. Matte highlight under my brows. Oh my goodness, go back in its place. But a video on my nails, I don't. What do you mean? They're just my nails. I don't do anything with them. Literally, don't do anything. Literally. I just let them be. Yes, background is different. Thank you, Nara. I think we're gonna call that. Okay, so I got one for a matte under my brow, and that's all I got. I don't know. I haven't paid attention to it lately. I think it's fine. I don't know. I don't think it's raining like it used to be. I literally never paint my nails. Like, I haven't done it in years and years. Are you going to be getting all the colors of matte? So there's a blue in there. I have every color. I'm not really sure. Oh, you're talking about the matte lipsticks. Yes. Like I said, all the colors. I'll use them all eventually. I kind of want to figure out what eye colors they would look best with, you know? But I will get them all and I'll use them all. I just used that a couple days ago, though, but I was doing something different today with my foundation. Yeah, I figured, yeah, matte lipsticks, you mean. I figured that out. I was like, blue? Okay, so now I'm gonna close up these. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna take some of Tenacious and put it here. No, my nails break if I try to paint them, okay? My nails cannot be painted or else they won't be long. And also, I am way too lazy. I haven't painted my toenail. I painted my toenails once since I moved to here, Japan, almost 5 months ago. Okay? I'm way too lazy to do that, let alone paint my nails, and I'm not paying somebody else to do that, okay? I'll pay somebody else to do things I can't do, but things I can do, I'm not paying other people to do. Nope, I like my nails natural as is. Okay, what am I doing? I want to do some liner. Do some proper pencil. It's our dark brown. Yes, but no. So, yes to your first part, no to the second part. So, it's supposed to be long wearing, yes. But not like the stains. So stains, you kind of need. The stains are a stain, if that makes sense. So it basically stains your lips, and it's harder to get off. The shine remover, makeup remover cloths work very easily for the lip stains to come off. But for the most part, it's not like it comes off very easy, and it's a little bit more dry on the lips. The matte lipsticks are like soft buttery. They take a little bit longer to dry on the lips. Like maybe a couple minutes to dry on the lips. But then as soon as it's dry, it's not going to go anywhere. It doesn't smear. It doesn't come off easily. But it's supposed to be able to be taken off easily with other things. They say probably about 6 hours is how long it's supposed to last. I'll see exactly how long it lasts me too. Like I was saying earlier, you can use some rose water. I have never had mine dry out yet, but I've talked to a lot of people that said rose water works. Yes, if you leave them open, you can't leave the cream shadows open. If you leave them open like an hour, okay, whatever. I've left them open while I'm on my video. But yeah, you don't want to leave them out overnight or anything. Yeah, I don't play by, but that's how a lot of people are. Hi, Patty. What was I gonna say? But yes, the cream shadows are coming out tomorrow. Or not the cream shadows. Well, there is one more cream shadow coming out tomorrow. The liquid lipsticks. I am so excited. I'm obviously getting them all. Takes me longer to get stuff here, so don't be asking me every day if I have it because it's gonna take me longer, unfortunately, to get here. And as soon as I get it, I'll be using one of my favorite colors probably first, one of the lighter ones. And then I will obviously go through all of them, so don't pressure me to go through all the dark colors quite yet. What was I gonna say though? Yes, but they're supposed to be soft and butter on the lips. You know, like other liquid lipsticks. I don't know if you've tried other liquid lipsticks, but typically they like are crunchy and hard on your lips, and when you like smile, they sometimes crack and they'll feel really drying. This is supposed to not feel it. There was other presenters that got it at convention, and they said they've been using it for months, and they said it never feels dry. So I'm really, really excited to see how it feels. I'm just gonna do a little bit of the pencil on the top. Any questions about anything? Okay, mascara. Oh goodness, oh. Mascara time. Hi, Kelsey. Got itches. I don't know what my dudes are ready. I got. Oh, Cream shadow's running all down already. See all those sparkles. Always what I like to do my eyes first. Hi, Brittany. So I like to blink the mascara on. Just gonna kind of curl your lashes up a little bit. Let me get my hair out of the way before I get mascara all in it. Not in like many, many years. Like, use fake lashes. I'm trying to think. Like, back in high school, I might have tried it like a couple times. But, like, early high school too. But that, I do not like gluing my eyes. I do not like that whatsoever. So just make sure you have plenty of gel to start. Thin out your lashes good. You know, bring these ones in, bring those ones out. I'm gonna take the fibers, they're loose, roll them on the back of your hand. Please make sure to do this, you're not gonna get too much on your lashes that way. And then just apply this mid to ends. Thank you, Kelly. Hope you are too. Mascara is water resistant, so you can get wet, you can cry, you can go in the pool. You can go out in the rain and it's not gonna smear, it's not gonna come down your eyes, it's not gonna burn your eyes, it's not gonna anything, but you can't rub your eyes. So if you rub your eyes, it's gonna go somewhere. If you rub your eyes when it's dry, I'm not saying it's gonna go anywhere, but if you get wet, just don't rub your eyes. So it's water resistant, not waterproof, but that makes it easy to come off at night. Because if it was waterproof, that makes it way hard to take off at night and scrub it off. Well, maybe kind of run out of gel before you run out of the fibers, but there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, the gel lasts me as long as I want it to last me, which is about a month and a half, 2 months, is how long it lasts me. So, I would never, like, 3 months is the absolute most. I don't care what mascara you use, I don't care at all. That's the longest. After you open a bottle of mascara, you should keep it. Bacteria starts growing over time, and you will... you know, your eyes will not like that. You know, building bacteria and stuff, it will hurt your eyes. No matter, and whatever mascara you use, mascaras, life cycle, 3 months. Please don't you stay it long, keep it longer than that. And that means after you open it, you can have a, you know, closed a little longer. But that's the biggest thing. Everybody's like, oh, I want the, you know, the mascara to last me longer. Well, no, it shouldn't. No mascara should last you that long. If you keep mascara for months, like, it goes bad. And I wouldn't say before you open it, maybe 6 months at the absolute most before you open it. If you, at some point, you know, it just starts to go bad. And I swear that goes for any mascara at all, not just ours. Mascara just types to, gets, grows bacteria faster. Again, the fibers are loose. Roll them back your hand. Give me 1 second. The allergies are killing me. Oh, goodness. Yes, yeah, same rules apply. Yep. Bacteria still builds over time. That's still, like, 2-3 months is still plenty of time for mascara to last. I mean, when I used to use mascara, like, from the drugstore, like, literally every week, maybe 2 weeks, I'd have to replace. Like, it would not last me long at all. Especially because I'd have to do it in like a million coats to get anything. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Caitlin. But yes, I just want to make sure these fibers are dried on good. But just certain products, like they say on the back of the shelf life, they say on the back of the, box for any, I couldn't talk, for any of the products that we or most products in general have. Got some questions? Always make sure to do 2 to 3 coats of the gel to finish. Thank you, Kelsey. Yes, I love these type of colors. Like I said, I mean, I feel like the Defiant looks great with my brown eyes too, but if you have blue eyes, you need Defiant in your life because they're really gonna make your blue eyes pop. Thank you, Alondra. You do it the way exactly I explain. So like make sure to separate your lashes as much as possible before applying the fibers. So plenty of gel and separating the lashes and then the fibers. If you don't roll them back your hand, it's just gonna get too much on your lashes. And then just very lightly just very lightly apply the fibers. I have a unique makeup trunk that I won earlier this year. And that's where most of my stuff is. Okay. Here we go, mascara done. Okay, sorry. I gotta put my hair back because I hate it behind my ears like that. Just does not look the same. That girl is totally flat. kind of depends what you want. How old are you two? Like, if you're under the age of probably like 35, I'd probably just use the uplift. I'm using the instant lift every day too, because the instant lift has so many long-term benefits too. But if you're not like, actually, you probably have to be at least 40, if not older. Like, it's more the mature, like it's more the 60s and plus, really, honestly, that's seen the very instant results of the instant lift. It has so many long-term benefits, so it's a great product. I use it every morning because I like the long-term benefits as well, but it doesn't give me any instant benefits. So it kind of depends what you're going for, but I've always loved the uplift for morning and night, always, since I've joined the company. So I think that's what I'd more lean towards. Yeah, there's nothing wrong. Like I said, I use the instant lift every day because there's so many long-term benefits and everything, but a lot of the same benefits are actually in the night cream as well. So I'd probably just get the uplift. Especially because you can use it uplift both morning and night still. Yeah, like I didn't want to ask your age if you didn't want to say it, but so I was trying to like give an age range of where the instant lift, you'll really see that instant results. Long-term benefits, everybody will start to see results in 4 weeks and it'll keep your skin youthful if you're not already. But when it comes to instant results, it's a little different. Okay, oh my goodness, let me get what I'm wanting to use right now. So, I'm going to mix, which two colors is kind of my color right now, but I'm going to mix our BB cream with a concealer. I used to do this more often. I just realized I haven't done that in a while. Actually, I don't know how long I've done that at all since I've been on Lives. I'm just going to shake up the BB cream good. But the BB cream is a tinted moisturizer. Doesn't have a lot of coverage. I just did it yesterday. I do it a lot of different days. I did it the past couple days. But I love it, just the BB cream, and then top it off with pressed powder. So this keeps my skin hydrated, but not oily, and the powder gives me the full matte coverage. But if you mix the BB cream with the concealer, I'm just going to top it off with a little bit of powder too. But if you mix the BB cream with the concealer, it gives more of the full coverage because the concealer is max coverage. So my liquid foundation brush is what I'm going to use to apply it. I'm just going to put some back in my hand. Actually, probably put way too much there. I kind of forgot for a second that I was mixing stuff, but whatever. We'll work with it. So I want to mix velour and scarlet concealers. And of course, I already have cat hair coming in this. Although he's not in the room, his cat hair's everywhere. How do you feel doing your makeup now? Especially live when you first started doing your videos. Well, thank you for saying I'm great at it. Oh wait, how do you feel about doing your makeup now? I feel good about doing my makeup? Especially live when you first started. When I first started my videos, I was definitely a lot less confident, but I've definitely gained a lot of confidence with this and this makeup and this, you know, I always feel uplifted and you guys love me in this video, so I love it. I'm definitely not a makeup artist. I never claim to be, but I definitely have fun playing with makeup. Oh, bye, Gabby. Hi, Becky. Yes, I love the backdrop too. I just got it a couple days ago. Okay, so then I got, this is a BB cream, this is a scarlet concealer, and this is the velour concealer. So I'm just going to mix them all together. That's just kind of what my color is right now. So I mixed it all, cut on my brush, it's evenly, put it everywhere. It's not gonna ruin the brush at all because these are synthetic bristles, but I'm going to wash my brush after today. You can apply with your hand if you'd like. I just feel like it goes on a little bit more even with the brush. Like I said, the BB cream is a tinted moisturizer. Feels amazing. It's actually a complexion enhancer too, so it's going to improve your skin over time. But the BB cream, the BB cream feels amazing. But the concealer is what's really going to give you the coverage. When you don't come on live or do your makeup, do you find yourself talking to yourself? If anything, I just talk to my cat a lot. But not really to myself. No. Maybe in my head, but definitely not out loud. Oh, I forgot. Should I do like a concealer under my brows to highlight? Like it's gonna Scarlet the latest concealer. I forgot. I was gonna do that and then I just totally set my mind. Or should I just leave it? So this combo's great. I have more oily skin, so I'm gonna tap it off a little bit with the pressed powder, but I don't really need too much more coverage, maybe just a little bit there on that one pimple, but I can also just go back through with the concealer to do just a little bit more. What was I gonna say though? What was I gonna say? But if you have drier skin, this is an amazing combo, because some people with dry skin don't even like the full matte look of this, and some people just don't like a full matte look. It gets a little less dewy with time. Don't get me wrong. I'll wipe that off my lips. That is way too much. But the concealer doesn't like, and this mix doesn't get to like a full matte look or anything like that. But it's not gonna come off like easily on your clothes or anything like that. But as you can see, blends in very nice. I like to mix a lot of colors. Some people can wear. If you guys watch me normally, I like mix random colors all the time. You know, scarlet and velour, sometimes I go through with organza too, like, sometimes I've gone even through with taffeta and mix that, like, I just go through with whatever works. But if you mix, like, two liquid foundations or liquid foundation and concealer, or a couple of concealer colors, it'll kind of get your perfect color. So if you're, like, one of those people, because there's a lot of people that are always in between colors, mineral makeup naturally blends into your skin easier than other makeups. I'm just going to go through with a little bit more concealer here. But mixing two colors is really nice to get that perfect color for your skin. And I used, if you saw, I used a little bit more of the velour than the scarlet. Yeah, the concealer. Okay. Hi, Vanessa. That's basically covered up. I'm gonna go through. I'm just gonna do a tiny bit of the Scarlet Concealer. I love how I decided to get a little bit more on one side than the other. But you can easily, like, that's what I love about this look foundation brush. You can just easily use it for your concealer as well. But you really don't want to use too much of the concealer. Just because it's thick, you don't need too much. You're just going to be wasting it if you use too much. You're going to notice it a little bit more. You just need a little bit. Do you want me to highlight with Curious or the concealer? Oh, wait. There was an eyeshadow. Oh, sorry. I didn't see Sydney's comment. There was an eyeshadow that she used the other day for. Yes, Curious. Yep, that was Curious. Thank you, Vanessa. Well, to get where I am today, I mean, I've been in just about 11 months now. Minus a couple days. So, to get where I am, 11 months. Because each and every day, I'm growing. It's always how it is. I'm growing as myself. I'm growing my team. I'm growing. That doesn't even mean just my numbers. I mean, I'm growing and helping my team. And I'm growing my following. I hope at least every day. That's why you guys commenting and liking and sharing and whatever you do always helps my business. And then of course buying does too. But if you can't or you already have people you buy from or whatever, liking, sharing at least just gets me and my name out there. So definitely appreciate that. Yes, of course. Just minus the shipping, but it costs like $2 or $3 to ship something back. But minus the shipping, yes, full refund. You have up to 14 days to return, which is also why I suggest using the product for the full 14 days. You can use it every single day of those 14 days to make sure. Don't just try something once and decide you don't like it. Especially when it comes to skincare, your skin takes a little bit of time to get used to new skin products. So it takes at least two weeks usually to get used to a skincare product. So use it for every single day, those 14 days, to make sure, you know, that you like it or not like it, that type of thing. And then you have up to 90 days to exchange. So in case you go over that, or you think you have up to 30 days. If you go over your time and for some reason you still want to return it, you can get an 80% return or a full exchange. So just exchange the product. What was I going to do? Oh, Scarlet. I think I'll do Scarlet in my one of my brows. But yes, I used highlight like Curious to highlight like right here to get that like shimmer. You can do that today too. So Scarlet's the lightest color. So I just like to use it. Like Scarlet is honestly the most concealer I've used more than anything else. Like Velour's more like my color. And can you see like, oh, there you go. Like I barely use any of this. And I've used a lot of this and I've had it for a while. And you can see there's still a lot of product in there. Totally not too much. Let's see, where's my concealer brush? Yes, exactly, Nikki. Sometimes it takes, I mean, depending on the product, like the mascara I love, but it will take you a couple tries to kind of get used to how the mascara works. So try it every day for a full 14 days. As soon as you get a hang of how the mascara works, you're good. But sometimes it just takes a little bit to get, you know, the hang of it. Too much, but way too much here. Oh, thank you, Hallie. Goodness, I got too much. Get some off. I want to get some off without getting like it all off. There we go. So if you want a matte highlight, like under your brow or whatever, you can either use this or use, and I haven't done that yet. I can always top that off with this or use fresh concealer. It's our lightest, loose concealer. Never really thought about that. I knew you could. I knew other people that did. I just kind of forgot. I'm gonna go back through Tenacious because I totally, like, I don't know, got away from, got too far down. This definitely feels really good. Like, I can feel my skin nice and hydrated, you know? BB cream definitely feels the best. I love it. If you guys have not tried the BB cream, it is awesome. It was definitely not oily at all, too, because like I said, I have oily skin. Thank you, Becky. And I'm just going to top it off with just a little bit of the powder. Actually, debating if I want to just do... Okay, and I'm going to do bronzer and blusher first. That's what I'm going to do. And then I'm going to go through the powder. Okay, so I'm going to go through with Sunset. It's our lightest bronzer. And I'm going to use a blusher brush. Of course, like I said, again, cat hair. Always. Just very lightly applying it. Because my face is a tiny bit still dewy. If I took the bronzer and like applied it too hard, my first spot, it would like show more. If that makes sense. If you can just apply it nice and lightly, it'll be good. And then apply it out. There we go. Just get a little color. I'm going to blend that little bottom line out in a minute with my Powder Puff brush. But I always suggest starting your bronzer at the outside because that will be what the darkest is, and then you blend it down. And the bronzer just gives you a little definition. I definitely can't stand my face without at least bronzer or blusher, if not both. Most days I use both, though. But some days when I don't feel like using bronzer, I'll just use a little bit of blush. Just give me a little color, like, in this area. And that's what I like. Go. What am I doing? Use some blusher. Let's use Scandalous. I haven't used Scandalous in a little bit. But the pinks and the initial bronze are awesome. You make, Carissa. I agree. Yes, I love fall colors like this. Thank you, Tiffany. Thank you, Abby. Thank you, Dana. Yes, exactly. Okay, so this is a, I don't know, like a reddish pink type thing. And I barely want to tap some on. Like barely tap it on. Okay, because blusher is very pigmented, our blushers. And you can easily blend it out, but just start... I like to start here and go like kind of on my contour and down into my contour. But I like the color, like, you know, in your cheeks. Kind of, that's where, you know, the color should be. You can kind of do what you want, but that's where I start and then I bring it back. And I'm gonna blend this out. Don't worry. Don't you worry. Like I said, barely. Tap a little bit more. It's hard for me to see. Barely tap some on. Plus, it's easier to add more. You can blend it out if you go too much, but don't be. If you be going like this with it, sweet might be the only color you can go a little bit rubbed. But they're all very pigmented, which just means they're gonna last forever. Barely tap some more. I don't want to like get too much on this side, but I want it to match a little bit more. There we go. Okay, so we blend it out, so don't worry. I don't want you guys yelling at me already. Yeah, you heard my cat. My husband woke up to go to the bathroom, and yep, there goes my cat meowing. Yep. No, that was like out in the hallway too. That's how loud he was. Awesome, Samantha. Thank you. I'm gonna use a little fresh concealer. That's what we're gonna do, and we're gonna put some of this under the eyes. So I'm going to take paper towel and make sure that my blusher brush is clean because I don't want some of that bronzer blusher to be coming off. So that's at least enough to make sure that it's clean. Go through with some of the fresh, which is the light concealer, the loose concealer, which is different than the Skin Perfecting Concealer. And just tap a little bit under here. Just to give me a little bit more highlight there. Just doing a bunch of stuff that I don't typically do. Thanks for the love. Somebody screenshot that, by the way, because I'll probably delete it by the time it's done. things. People are too much. Oh, people are just stupid. They think it'll affect, I don't know, affect something, I guess. It's usually just immature girls. Right, girls? If you put a mad face, if you're immature. You guys agree? Glad you agree. That's basically what it is. The mad faces, they'll delete them before, and the laughing faces, unless those are actual laughing faces, I don't know. Just screenshot those, because by the time I get off, they'll usually delete it, so I can't block them. But if you screenshot them, I can block them. And then they usually stop if somebody screenshots it. Love y'all. Like I said, put a happy face, or put any face if you love me. Any face or reaction you do is because you love me. That's what that means, okay, girls? Yeah, exactly. At first I look up and I was like, ooh, a lot of hearts, and then I saw those. People are funny. Thank you, Samantha. Thank you, Brittany. No, you don't have to buy the presenter's kit, of course, if you want to join and you want to get a discount, or if you want to sell, whatever you want to do, of course you can join, but you certainly don't have to. And this is one of the collection bags. I literally just got it yesterday. In the mail. So there's this one you get to choose, or there's a black and white striped one. But it looks a little too shimmery right now, but can you see how purple and metallic he is? I love purple. Can you see? It's like all glaring off of here, but I love. You see how big this is though? It's like literally the size of my head. I have bubble wrap to keep it full in here, but as you can see, there's a lot of room in here. So that's one of the collection bags. But if you go to uniquebeautybykayla.com and click sets and collections, and then you can go down to Most Wanted, which is a great collection. You get so many things and you save like $30. That's what's nice. You save about 20% off with the collections. And you get a free bag. Look how cute this one is. Or black and white if you don't like purple. Okay. Thank you, Dawn. Yeah, exactly, Jessica. Dawn, people are crazy. So they stopped. You are too much. Thank you, Becky. Thank you, Nikki. Oh, if you were to like click out of this real quick, it'll show all the reaction, like all the people that's liked and stuff. If you click like how many likes this video has had already, it'll show. It's not a huge deal. Nope, same spot, just got a new background a couple days ago, which I love. Exactly, it's only because they're jealous. That's how everybody is. Well, they just want to get a reaction out of any of us. Yeah, it's a good size makeup bag. It's big. My mom, okay, so like, I can't get the primer or the mask sent to me directly. Oh my god, more. To me. So I have to have it sent to my mom, and then my mom can send it to me. For some reason, those products can't send from Unique to me. It's weird, just by being API, just by being out of the States. So she was able to fit the mascara, liquid foundation, primer, a stain, and I think at least two masks, all that she put in here, just to save room, you know, obviously in the shipping bag. So like, it fit a lot in there. Thank you, Jennifer. Thank you, Stephanie. Thank you, Kaylee. Yeah. They already removed it. Exactly. So just do it like immediately. You guys don't have to, but it makes it the only way I can block them. Awesome, Vanessa. If you have any questions, definitely let me know. Exactly, Nikki. yeah, it's $99 to join. You get over $200 worth of makeup, and there's no other fees or commitments after. I'm just going to keep going in my highlighting spots. But yes, if you guys are also, if you actually want to work the business too, I'd love to help you out with that aspect. If not, I can just at least share, you know, any tips or even just to share with friends and family. But I got my own training pages. If you want to actually work the business, I'd love to help you out. I'm just going to use this fresh concealer everywhere. I like this. We'll highlight into there and blend that into there. Trying to reconnect. No. Really, Krista? I'm not sure. I know that people have been able to screenshot it, but I don't really know. You screenshot for me, Jayona? Because I don't, I mean, I watch some live videos once in a while, but I'm not able to always make it on people's live videos, so it's hard for me to know everything. Like, but I know people have been able to do it before. But I'm not really good with technology, honestly. It's not a huge deal, because it really doesn't affect me. Because they're just the immature ones. The thing is, I don't make any money from people doing that. They don't pay my bills, so I don't care what they have to say. I like you guys that help me in any way that you do, whether you're just commenting or liking stuff. They're actually helping my business if they don't realize, because even if they unliked those mad faces, it's still going to show up on their friend's newsfeed. So they actually are still helping me. Actually, keep doing it, because they're still helping me, because by doing any reaction on any of my videos, even if you delete it 2 seconds later, will show up on their friend's newsfeed. So we're just going to do that. You keep doing it, because you're still helping me. Yeah, I understand that, Jessica. Me too. Thank you, Tracy. Goodness. Oh, yeah, Becky? That's fine. I'm not sure, Carissa. So I don't even think I need to use a brush powder today. I feel like this fresh concealer might look a little light. You know what? I'm just go back through it a little bronzer. We're just not gonna use the brush powder today. Because I don't actually need, the brush powder is full coverage, so I don't need full coverage on top of this. I already have a lot of coverage, you know, from the concealer and the BB cream. Let's just add a little more color with the bronzer. Go. It'll work. But we'll see how this lasts. I'm really curious. I'll definitely let you guys know. Because I'm the kind of person that always like to use a pressed powder. But what's really nice is the loose powder pigments, these loose concealer. It's not meant for a lot of coverage, but it still gives you that matte type finish you like. And it's almost like a glowy matte, if that makes sense. You know, not as like dull. So it's really nice. I like that. I've totally used, like, my normal color is the Fabulous, like, and I've used that on top of, like, the BB cream and stuff before, and I like that a lot, but it's just really nice, because instead of having to use, like, two foundations to get even more coverage, because the powder's full coverage, there's no really need to use that on top of all this, and the concealer, I think, actually, is gonna last longer. There's a lot in here, you know, I only use a tiny bit to kind of just give me that mattness. You probably won't hate it as much as other looks. Okay, what did I miss? What should I do on the lips? Oh, I saw somebody, I don't know if it's gonna look good for this, but I saw somebody do our new popular lip liner, which is like the red, and then put Alphalete, if I can open it, on top. It looks like it'd be a weird combo together, but it looked really good on her lips. I feel like I wanna try that, but I don't know. Thank you, Dawn. Thank you, Gailey. It did turn out good for me today. I'm happy. Well, exactly. Just like I said, though, honestly, it's going to show up on their newsfeed, and I'm going to show up on their people's newsfeed, so that might be a good thing. Just help me reach more people. That's what this is all about. So they're actually helping me. I hope they realize that. Hey, Lisa. Thank you, Brittany, for explaining that. Yeah, try these. Sad faces, that's like different. Okay, so we're gonna try this. I got nothing on my lips. I did everything else, right? I hope. Always so hard for me to color my lips. Thank you, Christina. Thank you, Laura. Thank you, Kim. Yes, I love the fall colors. So all lip liners are like a full matte. They really will last you a while. They last me a square long and then stain sometimes. I love them. And this is one of the new colors that just released on the 15th. Think that's good. Looks like I got like a little pimple there, so it kind of looks like a little off right there, but it's okay. We're gonna use some of the Affulent. I don't know, should I keep it like an ombre or try to put it over the whole thing? Keep it like an ombre or what? I'm gonna just put a little bit on too, I didn't even put that much. Hi, Victoria. Oh, I barely ever just use a lip liner for liner. Actually, I don't think I've ever used a lip liner just for liner. But all the liners, we have 10 different lip liners. I could have 10 eyeliners too, and you can use them on your lips. I use them on the whole lip. It's a full matte look. It doesn't go anywhere. Like, I mean, it comes off like if you get like paper towel like wet, it comes off pretty decent. It's not like a stain where it's hard to come off. But it does not come off easily. You can drink and the water just like kind of beads up off of it. It doesn't smear. It doesn't come off like with kisses or anything like that. I love, love, love the lip liners on my whole lip. Nope, just new background, Laura. Okay, my back. That was taking way too long to reconnect. I just turned my Wi-Fi off, so I'm just on. Hopefully, I didn't lose all you guys. I'm back. Don't leave. No. What else did I miss? Oh, yes, but yes. Use a lip liner on your whole lips. You guys coming back? I'm back. I turned my Wi-Fi off because that was being really stupid. But yeah. Miranda, that just reminds me of like, you know, when kids are like in elementary school and the guys are like picking on the girls because they like them. That's probably what's some stupid thing like that. Pull a bit more ombre, entire lips look awesome. Oh my goodness, 50-50. Exactly, Joey. My internet was being bad. It was taking forever to reconnect, so then I just decided to take it off of Wi-Fi. So hopefully it shouldn't reconnect this whole time. Just bad connection. Awesome. No, that was my end. That wasn't your guys' end. You could try to get out and come back in. The lips don't matte. More lipstick though. Popular, our new lip liner that came out on the 15th. That is what I used, and then yeah. More like that. So that just made it darker. Oh, goodness. I see you right now, Brittany. I don't know if I missed. I don't think I saw anything before that. I mean, anything I see, I talk about. Not back to normal? I'm not sure. Is that good? Should I do something different? Definitely different. This one kind of reminds me a lot of Loaded. This looked a lot like Loaded lipstick. Like, a lot. I was expecting it. It looked a little kind of orangier on the girl I saw her do it. And I liked, like, the fall orangier type of look. Thank you, Miranda. Thank you, Vanessa. Should I just leave my lips as that? Definitely more pinky than I was thinking. Like I said, I thought I was thinking it was me more orangey, like fall-like colors. Thank you, Michelle. Don't know. I was hoping for more orange to like match my Defiant. What you guys think? Yeah, I understand that, Cindy. Yeah, that's why I wore this shirt today for my eyes. Back to normal. That's good, Carissa. Guess any questions before I get off? My lip sizes, keep it. Okay, awesome, Brittany. Really? See, I feel like my shirt looks more orange than pink, you know? I don't know, I wish you guys could see the picture that I saw of it. It looked, maybe just more the popular was coming out because it looked a little bit more orangey. Yes, you can definitely use the pigments on your lips. Definitely done that before. Thank you, Victoria. Thank you, Jet. If you guys have any questions ever, at any point, definitely message me. If you guys need a color match, just send me a picture of you in natural lighting. If you guys need, if you guys are interested in joining too, love to work with you. I'd love to help you out, help you get started, all that kind of stuff. Whether you just want it for the discount, whether you want to just sell to friends and family, or whether you want to make this your business like I do. Super fun. There's no commitments after joining, anything like that. I'd love to just have fun and work with you. Build your confidence up, all that kind of stuff, because my confidence has definitely gotten a lot better. I used to be like a nervous wreck, trying to do videos and all that kind of stuff. And just even my normal day-to-day life has changed, so it's awesome. You're welcome, Michelle. Okay, I think I'm gonna get off. I think that's all the questions right now, but you can definitely message me with any other questions. And I will talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching. Thanks for all the love, too, from you guys watching. And I will talk to you guys later. Like and share this video if you guys liked it. And I will talk to you guys later. Bye. Thanks for watching.